Hello, 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 all of you lovely viewers. We're back again. Game number two kicking off here for the Mr. Cat EU Invitational lower bracket game between PD and VP. The draft has begun as we get ourselves straight in and see a couple of junglers banned there by Pro Dota. A little bit annoyed against VP. I just lost and got stomped by a Templar Assassin. That Virtus Pro ran in the mid lane and gave a Bane to zone out a Shadow Fiend who had Cog Souls to begin with and got first blooded, and well, everything pretty much went wrong for Pro Dota in that game, honestly, Trent, didn't it?
What's a jungle? Is that where I go as Legion Commander with my Iron Talon? Is that what are these heroes? What is this deer lady?
I don't know.
Oh, so strange. It's been a while.
I think she likes touching animals or something.
Enchanting them even.
But the animals can't touch her back. It's a one-way street.
No, that is definitely true. Pro Dota, they're going to take the Bane for themselves this game. Clearly liked what they saw from solo and the way it helped out Virtus Pro. And VP, well, with no Enchantress, no Chen, no Bane, they offer a new strat. And that's going to be Shadow Shaman and Abaddon. So Abaddon, obviously very strong against the Bane. If you guys haven't seen that one before, your Fiend's Crypt, a Aphotic Shield.
You're Nightmared?
Aphotic Shield. Oh, maybe you're Enfeebled even.
You can't do that, though.
That one doesn't work, right?
No.
That's the beauty of strong dispels.
Can you BKB off Enfeeble yet? I don't think you can. I feel like Enfeeble is still like one of the only spells that you can't dispel or purge at all.
It is undispellable.
It definitely used to be that way. In the back of my head, I've got it in my head that something changed with Enfeeble to make something work where you could get rid of it. But maybe I dreamt it. Maybe I just got really annoyed at a Bane enfeebling me and I dreamt it.
He can still annoy you forever, because it's still the whole strong dispel kind of a deal.
Bane offlane is actually pretty strong. Remaining. Bane offlane, even a couple of patches ago, was very annoying. Just throw in. Especially, right, so back when Sven was, popular, maybe like three or four patches ago, if you were in, a 2v1 lane in a pub game and you had a Bane as the offlaner, he'll just enfeeble you and you can't hit creeps. You just can't hit creeps.
It's kind of like Enchantress offlane, where they couldn't do anything.
Yeah. Very annoying. So Bane Lina set up the Nightmare Stun with LSA, but Shadow Shaman's the one hero that we've got to talk about, right? 74 base damage.
Yes, he's flexing. He's got something going on. He is like the third highest or something stupid.
Yeah, it's like
right click now.
Treant.
Like what the hell?
Treant, someone, Shadow Shaman, then Tiny. Who's number two?
Oh great. You had to think of someone. Must be someone with a god awful attack animation. It wouldn't be Spearbreaker, would it?
No, he's definitely not up there with Treant.
You had to do this.
Come on, Trent, bring up the table of attributes.
Dude, I don't know. Oh, I guess I could do that. Alright.
I need to know now. It's tickling my brain. It's irritating me. I remember everyone like around it. It's like Treant, someone, Shadow Shaman, Tiny, but I can't remember who the someone is. Chaos Knight. Chaos Knight, dude.
Oh, okay.
Check it for me.
Tree, Chaos Knight, Shadow Shaman, Tiny.
I'm so good.
TL. I'm doing it by max though, to be fair. But it still ends up the same. Actually, if you go by damage minimum, Shadow Shaman is second because Chaos Knight has such a low minimum.
Yeah.
Wow, what is his minimum?
Like 42
or something.
His max
is 79. Yeah, his minimum is 49. I mean, dude, I know you take the Chaos Knight a little seriously. That's kind of crazy. So really, on average, Shadow Shaman's probably the second highest, right? Because of that spread. So he's actually the second strongest right clicker in the entire game.
Very strong. Very, very strong.
Damn, dude. That's crazy.
You know what else is strong? VP with IO. 5 seconds remaining. Oh, baby. Here we go.
Yep. New on to Sven. Set the play. Gives you some stun. They don't have any control coming up from their offlaner because it's an Abaddon.
And you don't want to Doom a Sven, especially not once he's popped his ults and his spells and he's blinked onto one of you.
Seems like a Sven game.
Definitely
feels
that way.
Could still be a tiny game too, though, to be fair.
That's an option.
Lina, Bane, Doom. I'm okay with playing tiny against those heroes.
What does a Doom bring you this game for PD? I guess you can Doom the Abaddon, make sure he can't get his saving abilities out onto people. Io and Shadow Shaman are very squishy as well, but it's going to be the Bristleback.
Oh, you definitely don't want to Doom him.
Certainly not.
Now let's see if an Aghanim Scepter apply that break. So, I think Doom one of the benefits, maybe it won't come into play, but the idea that you can definitely track down this Io, like, super early on and make sure he's not getting mega greedy with stacks and everything. You can just, like, run into the jungle and abuse him. 5 seconds. That is a valuable thing to have on your team. But they need to find some AoE for this Io, because right now they have nothing. Assuming this is... is this a Doom 4? I would assume it is, but then they need some, like, serious AoE from their 3. They don't really have space for, like, a Disruptor or anything, or a Winter Wyvern, unless they want to make this a full core Doom. Yeah, exactly. That's, like, I don't know. Did he win last night? We had him in a game. I think he lost.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, he lost. We had a lot of Wombo combo going. There was a Silencer Void on one side, and then a Tidehunter on the other, so it was cool. Jeez. Cooldown Dota was back.
Okay. Well, Vengeful Spirit will give you a swap onto the Io to, you know, set up for things like Lina and Bane to actually catch the little ball of light. I was feeling, you know, some kind of mobile carry, maybe, you know, Ember Spirit safe lane or something along those lines, but...
Yeah.
That's risky.
Xiaoshan's a little scary. 10 seconds remaining. But, so is rather than that, the catch is weak.
So is the Abaddon in lane. 5 seconds
remaining. Yeah.
I mean, Virtus Pro, they still have options here. They could, you know, go... oh god, okay. I mean, like, VP could go dual lane mid, Io Bristleback, which is what I feel is going to happen with that Brood ban now thrown out. Then Abaddon off lane, but it could equally be Abaddon in a safe lane, then go an aggro dual lane with Shadow Shaman plus one. Shadow Shaman just right clicks people, starts punching them, have someone who's, you know, tanky enough to go and sit in the creep wave.
Do you know what would be an ancient meme? If we had a Ramsey's Gyro here, that would be fun.
Mm.
Just saying, that would be a pretty good time. I'm kind of expecting the dual lane mid, and then they're just going to run this, like, Xiao Shaman plus one in the safe lane, but Prodota, they're still a little bit wary of that mana battery, as it was always called, with the Io and the Storm Spirit. Could have been very handy to have his two, and just throw Ramsey's the Bristleback safe.
So what are they looking for? I mean, it's pretty certain going to be their offlaner, right? I don't think you'd run Doom in the 3... at all.
I don't know. The more I think about it, the more I think he needs, like, a Shadow Blade and stuff to be useful this game, so I almost want to make Doom the 3, but then I have, like, a Doom, Lina, Venge core.
Yeah.
Like, who's my Venge saving? The Lina, I guess? Do I have a different position? One hero that could save this?
I mean, I would kind of like an Elder Titan here for PD, but then I don't know where to fit it in. And you've got ability to stop this Io from relocating in. You've got great team fight. You synergize well with Lina and Bane. Bring back the ET offlane. Bring it back.
Yeah, I'm really not sure. Batrider is a kind of a classic hero for 3-3. Maybe they'll just, like, fall into it and be like, okay, you guys want a bat? Can we make this work?
Nyx Assassin, mana burn against Bristle. Actually, I think Nyx is probably the best hero here. I was thinking about, you know, Legion Commander and all that, because Legion's very good against Bristleback, very good against Io. You can buy Silver Edge, you got the break, but you force Bristle to face you when he's fighting. Could definitely be an option here, and it also offers you some good D push.
Yeah, I like the Legion.
Whoa.
All right, that's a classic 3-3 hero, but certainly not one we were expecting. So he's a very good Lone Druid player. He played it a lot when the hero, like, right before he rose to prominence, he was playing it quite a bit before any other teams really were. And then once he got a couple more buffs, it was very helpful for this guy. Very good player. Assuming it's him. Maybe they'll give it to someone else. I'm not sure. But I think it's going to be 3-3 playing it. And he was playing in an offlane role back then. So I have to see exactly how this winds up with some of the changes the heroes Wraith received.
King. Cool. Ramsey's Wraith King. I mean... we're kind of expecting Venge 1 roll here, right? But it could still be a support. No, it's going to be the Garter 1 roll. It's pretty much 90% of the time that's how they run the Venge on PD. Wraith King for Virtus Pro.
Yeah, so we will get our mid duo.
You don't want to Doom him. You don't want to Laguna Blade him. You don't really want to Fiend's Grip him. I mean, I guess you could burn his mana with Fiend's Grip, but...
And the bear. What a perfect pick.
Oh, yeah. The
super counters Doom and Lone Druid. As he gets the neutral critical on the Lone Druid Bear.
Was it
you guys. So basically, it's crazy. It's 500%, isn't it?
500%?
Maximum or something stupid? Yeah, it's like a 500% crit.
What?
Yeah, because it's 250 on a hero and 500 on a creep. Pretty sure.
Oh, yeah.
That's actually insane. Filthy.
Very, very cool. Oh, VP.
Oh, God, what an ownage pick. Damn, that is so good.
Andy has the IO under Baden. Like,
I actually feel so bad for Bro Dota
so
right now.
VP have three unkillable heroes already. Bristle, Wraith King, Abaddon, like, unkillable. Then they have Lil's IO behind them to make them more unkillable. So they are the unkillablest. And then they have a Shadow Shaman who's just like, yeah, I'm going to throw wards into these fights. bit of control.
The Lone Druid, happiness that has recently occurred, though. So he actually got a lot of buffs. The Rabbit attack speed was increased from scaling from 10 to 20 to 30 to 40 to now starting flat out at 20, which is pretty helpful, to 30, 40, 50, and then most importantly, the duration. So it's now been rescaled to 25 at all levels, a little bit worse later, but definitely better early on. And then the cooldown was also reduced by 10 seconds. So now we're getting, because it used to be nonstop Rabbit, but now there's only a 10 second downtime. So you essentially have like 66% uptime or whatever for Rabbit all game for the Lone Druid. So much better than what it was after the nerf.
Trent with the mathematics. 66% or whatever. Very, very good.
Yeah, it's not actually that. I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I was just throwing it out there.
That's fine. PD, they've got smoke over on Milan. It looks like they are going to go for a wander. 3-3. Doesn't want to join them. Heads down towards the Radiant Jungle Bounty Rune.
It's actually about 70%.
Solo gets a ward up, but he won't see them moving on forward like this. Is this going to be an aggro tri-lane here? Milan plays in the aggressive jungle, in the dire jungle. Garter and J4 play up on this offlane. They're looking for a kill. They're hunting for someone. Solo, he's in a decent position to pop this smoke and run away. He's slow, but he's just about fast enough to get away from Garter's Venge, and Ramses will retreat as well. One of the ugliest swords known to man, the Blood Shard. Equipped. There are so many cool weapons for Wraith King, and he chooses that one.
I like it. You don't like it?
No.
Well, it's cool. It's like, it's a little subtle, you know?
Subtle?
Yeah. It's like not huge. I don't know. Yes, color-wise, it's not very subtle, but size-wise, you know, he's showing he doesn't need a, you know, what is everyone else compensating for?
Why is his bright red?
You don't want to know. He's had some issues. Okay. I think this aggro makes a lot of sense, though. If you're going to make this Lone Druid work, yes, it's 3-3 playing it. It's your offlane player, but it's always a hero that goes in the safe lane and has a happier time, gets much more farm.
Three bounty runes go their way as well. Oh, hello. Solo and J4, a bit of a scuffle in the jungle. Three heroes here as Milan shackles up, and with the Curse of the Avernus from Pasha, getting in onto this Doombringer who doesn't have anything skilled up just yet. He's dead. First blood goes the way of VP. As this aggressive lane got a little bit too aggressive, it looks like, and they move Pasha top. VP do. They swing Ramses down towards the bottom lane to deal with 3-3's Lone Druid, but they need some supports down there as well, because the mid lane, of course, is the dual lane.
3-3's trying to put as much pressure on as possible right now on the Ramses, because he sees them. He's like, oh, you do not have your Stoat Shield yet. I need to beat the shit out of you if I'm going to have a hope of this lane. The supports are coming, though, and just be expected. But Doom's coming, too, so it'll be a little bit of a awkward 2v2. And looks like J4 is on the hunt here, trying to find this Abaddon, and I don't think he knows where he is, judging by the fact that he's running in circles in the tree line.
As Pasha just found a nice little spot for himself. Oh, there we go. He's found. J4 places a ward down as well to see these movements come through. 3-3 burns through a salve already as Solo. Looks like shackles were used down in this bottom lane. This Lone Druid's relatively quick on his feet.
Milan's coming in, but I don't think they can do anything to Ramses.
Maybe he's going to Solo. Orb of Venom on the bear slows him down, but Milan can't get close enough. Even with this Alpha Wolf aura, they're chasing this. They're actually going to try and commit. Oh, look at that. Okay, first hit crit from Milan. That should secure the kill with a final little axe thrown by 3-3's Lone Druid. Good stuff.
What a great creep to have. The Alpha Wolf when you have a bear and a Lone Druid. Increase both of their damages. That was pretty cool.
Solo TP's and, down straight away.
Hey, that was a rabbit at work as well. Right? Yeah, now, instead of like 10 attack speed, that was 20 attack speed. So that's the buff right there for you.
It's like the movement speed as well. He was so quick, even without boots, just chasing down the Shadow Shaman. Now he's got brown boots as well. Might give them over to his bear. But needs them for the defensive moves, because with the Wraithfire Blast,
oh,
good
nice
body
blocks.
3-3. Keeps Solo at bay as he gets his hero out of range of the shackles. Very nicely played. Mid lane, Lil still hanging around. Is he trying to get some stacks up or anything? Looks like he's got a couple, yeah, a couple of very good top stacks lane. Over in the dire jungle. Pasha, trouble, dead. J4 and Garter. Find the kill on the offlaner there.
Tried to trade away with Garter a little bit too deep there, basically. He's getting a little bit trigger happy with his Reaper's sight there on this guy. You see this thing? Pasha's wielding. It's got like a halberd.
Oh, wow.
I wouldn't want to mess with this guy. That thing's huge.
Look
it's
at
very
the,
frightening.
Look at the animation of it as well. It's, yeah. It's as though it's made of air. It just, you know, slices through the sky.
Look at that damage.
Wasted a shield. Well, not wasted a shield, but the shield was popped instantly by J4's brain sap. Milan gets killed off, but top lane, it's still this weird battle where Pasha's very nearly dead. What's he up to?
You're crazy.
Shield out onto the creep, he's trying to pop it back onto Garter, but six stick charges on the Vengeful Spirit means that a turn and a stun is definitely available for the Venge, and Pasha, he is towing the line so very carefully.
Oh, and look, he's going to try and make a play using this ward here. Bane's going for the long con. He's like, yeah, I know where you are. I've got a ward down. You're in trouble.
Well, Garter just goes straight up with the magic missile. I don't know what Pasha was thinking there. Bottom lane, Ramzes run down by 3-3 in Milan, but in comes the Io, the shackle to turn. Where's that Wraithfire blast and the Aether shot coming through? They've got the damage and they turn for 3-3 as well. Unfortunately, no mana over on Ramzes for another stun, and the very, very speedy lone druid manages to skirt the fight. Ramzes might think about another stun back onto the bear, but holds onto it for now.
Yeah, too worried about just getting disjointed or something, I guess. Wow. Jeez, Pasha, please. Hey, you know it's bad when you're running back to lane, you can't even TP. Radiant's top tower is under. Garter gonna use this time to also just run right back to base. He's not gonna miss too much. I missed a range creep and a couple melees, but he'll get back for the next wave, and it's also still gonna be close to his tower, so this will be a worthy trip back home.
What's going on Solo. Down here? He's got the Io behind him. Lone Druid sprinting on through, but the shackle there from Solo holding Bane in place, but in comes Milan. One swipe, another crit. The first hit takes down the little Io. Solo is saved. PD, they're making some good movements here. You know, they're kind of consolidating their lanes, making sure 3-3 gets some farm. But 12 last hits, 5 minutes in, when you look at the Bristleback and the Wraith King, 36 and then 19. There's a massive amount of farm on no one. Lina, we've not looked at too much. Kaiser doing decently at mid, but up against no one's Bristleback, it's not an easy task, especially when there are, you know, these stacks that have been made up for the Bristleback to catch up, not, well, I guess, overtake even further. Stun again. Good initiation. 3-3's caught with a Savage Roar. He sends the back, and there was a bit of overlap there from Virtus Pro. With their stuns. Very difficult to kill this lone druid, and now he's got two supports behind him. Milan and J4, they're looking for this movement forward, but the Dire Observer Ward scouts them out perfectly. Ramzes is just holding his ground. He knows exactly when he needs to run, exactly when he needs to bail, and this is the moment. Solo and Lil still behind him. Tether, movement speed, get him further away. So these lanes have pretty much devolved into a 3v3 bot lane and a 1v1 top lane.
And a dual lane mid that never really happened. You know, Io Bristle, of course, very omnipresent in the mid lane. Pretty common thing to have, but not this game. It's very nice when it's the bottom lane you're rotating to is this Io, though, because he still has that like threat of showing up mid, and that's why this ward is here from the Radiant, just spotting when this is coming through, much like it is right now. So Kaiser, see, they weren't smoked or anything, right? Like, he did see them rotate over. Yeah, and now he's playing the edge here. He knows this is coming.
Ramzes tries. He won't get anything done, though. Wraith King, where are you going?
Yeah, this could be a big miss for VP.
Yeah, like, well, there are bad on top lane. No one's trying to sprint forward. Solo scouted Garter. He cuts across. The trouble is Ramzes. Nice nightmare. J4 stops it, but the turnaround here as Ramzes gets the nightmare taken off him, and the stun onto Garter means they secure a kill. I don't know if they can chase in onto J4. He's very quick on the Bane.
They lost bottom, though. You know, they make a giant rotation across the entire map. Lone Druid just pressures down bottom with the Doom. They take the tower, and they open up about a 1,500 gold lead for Pro Dota. Kaiser also now pressuring mid, too. Pretty farm, just clearing waves. Don't know if it was actually worth it. At least they got the Venge right at the end. Then it would have been quite the disastrous rotation with Pasha going down as well.
Wait, what's Venge buying? Oh, is that Helm? That's the new Helm recipe, right? Yeah. Eventual Spirit, Helm of the Dominator. Okay. Interesting. I mean, usually we see Helm to, you know, create stacks, build up economy, then go and clear them with AoE, you know, Sven or Luna or someone like that, but with Eventual Spirit, I guess you're just going to be looking to maybe take a Centaur or a Hellbear, you stun swap into that combo with one of the neutral creeps you pick up.
Maybe even like a... it's going to be hard to use, like... Well, I guess you can get the Purge creep. He'll live pretty well with the extra HP, even against Quill Sprays and stuff like that.
Or Mana Burn.
Handy for controlling.
Mana Burn the Wraith King. Oh, yeah. I guess later on, you've got the Alpha Wolf potential as well, just to amp up all your damage. Doom can get a Vlad to swap in onto Ramses. He doesn't have his ult skilled up. Turns to stun, and in they go onto Garda's Venge. Locked in under this tower as the Nightmare comes through. Ramses has his ultimate now, and it will be popped to slow Garda down near this tier 1 tower. Vengeful Spirit, unfortunately, going to drop, and the TP's cancelled out. J4 won't escape. Bane chased down into the secret shop, and VP. Perfect rotations in. Perfect level up there as he held the point on Wraith King to get that ultimate. All baited out. All guaranteed. But Prodota still pressure on mid tier 1. And 3-3 is farming.
Next time, he might have to worry about Bane. But for now, still level 4. No Fiend's Grip to drain the mana just yet. I guess even if you get a full 5-second duration, you get, like, what, 25% of his mana, so... It's not too shabby. It is based on the maximum, though, so that's kind of cool. So he legit does get, like, 25% total Wraith King mana, which is quite a bit. I mean, 360 mana.
Yeah, it's a good chunk. Ramses is looking for that stun. No one is in the thick of things here, with the damage from his Quill Spray stacking up with the Nightmare. Slows it down, solo turned around on, and killed off by Milan and J4. Magic Missile, again back onto the Bristleback, but Virtus Pro, a little bit awkward there with no Lil Wisp. He's actually back over towards his Ancient, stacking up it looks like. DD Rune bottled, maybe Leeching Experience mid, trying to get into that level 6. Still level 3 only. Something VP definitely have to worry about is the levels on their supports. Shadow Shaman and Io, both relatively greedy experience-wise, if not gold-wise.
Yeah, but look at this stack, though.
Yeah.
Like, the Bristle's gonna come and annihilate these, and these guys will be very happy. They missed one of them, but he also has a shitload of Ancients. He's got some on the North Camp, he's got some on the South Camp, and with the Vanguard, these just die. Those are already gonna start helping out with the DD rune here.
And that was going to be so many levels.
I'm so excited to watch his levels.
So many levels. Here we go, Lil.
Did he just clear all the camps?
Yeah, where does he end? About it. Yeah, he's actually saying to no one, hey, get the core sprays over on these guys as well. Pull them across.
Let me just grab
look,
this camp.
Look at this. Okay, Lil's level 4. He's going to get level 6 from this, right? He's going to be very close from all three of these stacks because there's still large creeps remaining. Level 5 is very nearby. Pulls across again. Wow. From level 3 to almost level 6 in a matter of like 20, 30 seconds. That's a huge bonus there from Virtus Pro. No one, of course, reaps the benefits, reaps the rewards. PD, they want to contest this, but the stacks have already gone. Kaiser and J4. Oh, maybe they just kill off Lil. Yep, there we go. See ya, buddy. Laguna Blade to the noggin. Takes him down. No one chases in, though. The Yule's up onto the Wraith King means there's no stun the Nightmare. Also, delaying that advance forward.
Well, that was pretty good.
Look at no one. No Solar Crest, which is kind of what became the expected item for Bristlebacks. Going for Vanguard into Radiance.
I like it. He knows he's a bunch of gold stacked up for these Ancients, through these neutral camps. So, not something that was quite as easy to do last patch, even when Bristleback was starting to gain popularity right near the end of 7.05. So now you just rush right into that Radiance.
And I guess if you know the Lone Druid's going Radiance, you meet Radiance with Radiance.
Yep. I guess we didn't talk about it, but I guess we were kind of assuming it would be a bear build, right?
Yeah.
Makes sense.
It's pretty much become the norm nowadays.
Yeah.
But then it does leave the question open, what does Ramses go for? Because he's buying a hand of Midas now, 12, 13 minutes in. He'll have it very soon. But after the Midas, what do you expect from him?
I was actually... Well, for him, he can't go Radiance, obviously, yeah, so just like Maelstrom and Blade Mail and those kind of items, I would guess. Could get an armlet, too. I don't know if that's too late for that, but kind of good against this team. Now I'm kind of curious about Lone Druid's talents though, because now I'm just thinking like level 20, there's actually no non-bear choice now, because with the respawn talent removed, it's 50% Spearfarer magic resistance and 12 Spearfarer armor. So the lonely druid of bearlessness is actually quite a bit worse now.
Yeah. What do you go for here? Go for 8 HP, Spirit Bear damage, Spirit Bear armor, I guess, this game. Oh, Shackle. A bit of a team fight going off as Kaiser, again, just blasts the IO with another Laguna Blade. Solo's chased down by Milan. Scorched Earth and a bit more damage will finish him off. Solo taken out by Kaiser. He's on a killing spree at this point, and with no one, actually held in the Fiend's grip and entangled up. This is PD getting a triple kill on their Lina. A huge skirmish over towards their shrine. Verse Pro thought they were strong, but they were shown to be completely wrong.
Wow. I mean, again, when you're just blowing up this IO every single fight, though, that takes away a lot of the whole purpose of picking this hero. It's just like keeping this Bristleback alive and alive, and you can't deal with him. And when you're saving so much of your money to invest in this Radiance, like if he had the Solar Crest, that fight could be totally different. But instead, you're just holding all this net worth. You don't get any interest, sadly. I'm not sure if they want to be that deep in enemy territory again until they have it finished.
So VP's plan here is just to buy lots of Hands of Midas. Abaddon has one, Wraith King's buying one. Come on, Bristleback, just buy a Hand of Midas.
Yeah, jump off that Radiance. Just buy a Midas.
Just buy a Midas, my dude. You know you want
together.
To. You know you want to. But I think it's time to give Ramsey some farm. He's moving into the Blink Dagger to give him some kind of initiation tool. Because they can't have the IO moving into the front lines like they have in the past couple of fights. It's been incredibly poor from them. PD smoke up. There's a haste rune bot that they can take. But look at this. Lil wanders over. He sees the Bane. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. That's the rune.
Oh my God.
That's the annoying rune. He gets Nightmared, Elisade, and kill. Doesn't even get the haste rune.
Oh, Kaiser bottles it up. And I love Kaiser's build this game, too. Yule Scepter and then right into that Shadow Blade to build the Silver Edge against the Bristleback. Bloodstone, not really a necessity. The Yule's very valuable up against the Shadow Shaman. Can stop him from channeling on one of your allies that have to waste your LSA on him. You can just throw the Bristleback up in the air for a little bit to try and ignore him. And there it is, that Helm of the Dominator, the Hellbear just tanking some waves and clearing creeps. Still a good item, despite all the nerfs.
Yep. Still very strong.
Trying to find a swap there.
PD are knocking on the door of the tier 3 already.
And look at Garter's items that he has queued up to. He's looking like, I'm gonna get my treads, I'm gonna get a medallion, I'm gonna turn that into a solar crest. Like, I am set for the next while. I know my place. I'm just gonna help back up my lone druid and my Lina.
I'm gonna tank up, make sure I don't die. Get some big swaps. Now they've taken over this dire ancient area. Pasha and Solo, good hex to slow things down, but still with a swap back, I think that's inevitable. Death will be coming. And you know, in the meantime, Trent, this 3-3 Lone Druid is still farming away. Kind of ignored.
So is Ramsey's, though. Like, he's been totally ignored for the past while. He's just been punching the same. Every time I look at him, he's in this exact same creep camp.
Yeah, he has just been cycling through these, you know, three or four jungle camps for the past 2 or 3 minutes. Kind of insane. J4 gets an observer ward down, but scouted by no one as he made the move over. PD looking to play aggressively over on the dire side of the river. There's a big ancient stack there that maybe they could try and steal. Oh. I don't know who would clear it. Maybe the Lina with the damage she's got. You know, there's some good gold waiting there for them. But Lil and Ramses are up on the high ground. Looks like VP are converging in on that area as well. With no one having 4,200 gold, he's got pretty much enough money for his Radiance.
Bit of an interesting game here, though. Rather large edge here for Pro Dota, surprisingly so, of course, as VP certainly considered the favorites, but we said the same thing against Empire yesterday, and those next two games did not go quite as easily for VP, and it was very similar to how game one went. They absolutely stomped, dominated, crushed, not even close, and then game two and three, you were just like, what? What happened?
Yeah,
where'd it go?
what's going on?
But I love the draft. You know, I can see the ideas behind everything here for VP. I think everything was looking very good, too, right up until that just right here, right? There's that one mistake up in the top lane near the Radiant Tier 1. And maybe they are missing a little bit of building pressure. You know, Bristleback's good at sieging buildings, but that comes later in the game, very early on. Not so great at it. Could be one thing that's slowing them down here. There are some nice counter picks in some ways too, like that Doom up against the Abaddon can be very helpful. He throws that out. The Laguna Blade's been annihilating Lil, so they haven't really had a chance to use any of their sustains so far. And the itemization's going to be pretty late from solo in terms of any like initiation or mobility during the team fights. But later and later, I'm definitely not counting out VP. I think Xiao Shaman is extremely good going later and later to help like trade towers and whatnot. Of course, even Io did the same thing.
Yeah.
You have this Wraith King that gets insane.
Especially
go back for the armor. He canceled his blink purchase, actually. Interesting.
Especially when
their
it comes to... Yeah, especially when it comes to stopping Lone Druid from split pushing with a Radiant, you know, having a relocate plus a shackle from Shadow Shaman or something like that to set things up. Just relocating a Wraith King in to start off a little team fight. But PD, they've got such a strong four-man roaming squad here as they're showing off with a smoke up towards top lane.
It's quite the move, though. They have a ward here, and they have a ward here, and they smoke up in here. Really hoping someone's getting greedy down in this area or something, but... That, like, so unlikely you catch anything, and now there's Xiao Shama de-warding their ward.
Yeah, no one scouted out J4 placing it. Ramsey's... Oh, nearly found. Does wander himself away, though, but the pressure comes in onto the tier 2 top lane. Kaiser, Shadowblade and Yule's done, aiming for the Silver Edge as well to deal with that bristle back. It's Lone Druid, 3-3, he's got his Relic. No Radiance just yet as Pasha comes in to try and halt this push coming in. Deter them away with just his body. The Abaddon runs into the creep wave, but here we go. Radiance for Bristleback with his Vanguard. Radiance now for Lone Druid. Literally the same time. Well played, well played. Well, wraparound's coming in. Solo smoked up here, looking for a pick onto someone. This is going to be a full 5v5 as Ramsey's started up on, and look at that damage. He's obliterated there. Garter just swapped him into death. No one chases forward in onto the Ventral Spirit. The Savage Roar sends the Wraith King back with Pasha, but they've doomed the Bristleback. He's still got Radius Burn going, and he just whacks down the Doombringer. One more hit, he's gone. The Root's there, but Lil saves up Solo, keeps him alive. Kaiser, did he Laguna Blade and Dragon? What just happened? VP are just storming through this fight. The Spirit Bear is being chased by no one's Bristleback, who lost no HP through the Doom. He's dead. 300 gold, 300 experience. Thank you very much, Savertus Pro. What a simple team fight.
I'm trying to find it. Yep, Ancient Black Dragon. Lina cast ability, Laguna Blade on Ancient Black Dragon. Ancient Black Dragon received modifier. Lina Laguna Blade. Got him for 206 damage. Wrecked. Yeah, that's not good. That was oh my god, that jeez, that graph just
but that's their lead gone. Just like gone completely.
And I was I was about to say before that fight started, I was just thinking, you know what? The more I think about it, the more I like what ProDota did. Like having this vision and still smoking up through here to this tower, because I think what they were saying was, all right, we know we have a little bit of an edge in the tower push game. We have this Lina, so if we can just dodge them and not fight a Bristleback and a Wraith King, that's probably a pretty good idea, you know? We can just close up these objectives. They can't trade evenly with us right now. The Xiao Shaman's, you know, he doesn't have the mobility or the speed to get around the map to keep pace with us, and now even right away, they're just going right back for a building. Which I do like this decision. It is still 2-minute cooldown. Remaining here, in fact, it was the level 1 ulti.
I mean, no one is unstoppable at this point, he's just going on in, the Nightmare's taken away from him, Wraith King in the back end, Ramsey's no ultimate, he's Fiend's gripped up, but no one is just slamming people, he's taking these fools down with him, he's full HP, he's got Lil on his back, the Yule Scepter there from Kaiser keeps him up as well, but Garter chased down by Pasha and no one, he's looking for 3-3, one more hit is all he needs, and J4 is going to be another casualty of war, a Nightmare again back onto no one, but it's taken off him again, Kaiser, he's found a kill in the back end. As Wraith King as well as Shadow Shaman have fallen, but this is all the No One Bristleback show. Chasing in onto Milan, unkillable, and destroying Pro Dota with another kill. It's a dominating streak for No One. Now looking for a tier 1. Virtus Pro, they've come out of the gates. 8 minutes in. Sure enough, they were behind by, you know, 5,000 gold, but that one Radiance, that one fight, that one missed Laguna Blade, and Virtus Pro are very calmly in the driving seat.
Like, Io and Abaddon don't die, and this draft, you can see it all in your own god. You actually can't deal with these two frontline tanks and the Wraith King and the Bristleback. You can't find a way to worm your way into this Io and Abaddon. It's just too much damage, it's too much sustain. Roche is feeling that pain too.
Whoa. A tragedy, an absolute tragedy, Trent.
That, what a swing. 9k gold in a matter of minutes here.
Absolutely.
This looks a lot better, that's for sure, compared to how things were starting out and how game two went yesterday. VP gonna try and hold this lead, and they play right again after if VP were to win this, correct?
Yeah.
We just go straight into a match against Secret, which is pretty cool, so it's a double header for whoever grabs this.
Not exactly straight into it. I think we still start on
schedule. Starts in an hour and a half.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm just thinking now, like, how
you're
many...
You're just thinking?
I'm just thinking. Colon thinking colon. How many other times have we seen, you know, big spells thrown onto creeps or neutrals or anything? You know, there was the
Stun the Boar.
Stun the Boar by Sokshka back at, was that TI3 qualifiers? When you played for,
yeah.
for Quantic?
Yes.
I want to say, or was it DD when you played for DD?
One of the, it was Quantic, it was, but I think it was Quantic.
One of the two. But I can't think of anything else. Just like, spells being thrown into...
Chad will have some good ones. There's some classics I'm sure we're just not thinking of.
Yeah, I bet. Well, Ramsey's now. Is that Blink Armlet done? Yep, he's found himself in a good spot.
Nothing quite like Stun the Boar, though. Stun the Boar really was on all of them. It was right up here, up on this ramp. Stun the Boar. Oh, God, that was a beautiful moment. Not so much if you were part of it, though, I'm sure. Stun the Boar.
You okay there, Trent?
There's not many that go down in such infamy as Stun the Boar does.
No,
there's
one.
There's honestly Aegis Deny, the play, Stun the Boar. Those are three of my top moments in Dota.
Yes, there are tier 1 still standing over on the Radiant side of the map. Tier 1 top and bottom lane. I think VP have realized, hang on a second, there's gold to be claimed here.
Yeah, I mean, this Bristleback's about to have an Octarine core. He can hit buildings now. I think his life's okay. And this was an item people said. I think they weren't really seeing, you know, they were just will you even get Octarine Core now? Because of the talent, right? Because now at level 20, he gets a 10% spell lifesteal, but now it's just going to be doubled up, essentially. You really want that CDR, though. That's got to be the biggest thing about Octarine Core, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, most certainly. There it is, fully complete. Is that Silver Edge? It is from Kaiser, but he still definitely cannot solo kill this no one Bristleback and Lil. He's in such a good position behind him to save if anything does go wrong. Tier 2 bot is going to fall as 3-3's shoving top lane with the help of
courier.
The Doom.
The Dire did. Ward. Yeah, they know for sure there are people up here.
It looks like Solo, Pasha, and Ramses, they're making the kind of movement across towards mid lane, maybe to find someone who swings mid to try and farm, but it'll be the TP down towards bottom by Kaiser to get that creep wave, while the other pack of four here from PD just stick together, make sure none of them get picked. Now, we've not seen any relocate saves or really aggressive relocate plays. Lil has just been able to tether people. You know, the first two times he died because of Laguna Blade.
There were some issues.
But then the next couple of times he's just been, okay, I tether you and then we win the fight. And here we go. Okay, aggressive relocate play. This is what I want to see. Milan shackled up and immediately dead. No one continues his streak. The chase continues with Ramsey's looking for another stun. Don't know if he'll find it though as PD retreat back behind their tier 2. There's a little purge creep there, slowing Ramses. That's gonna piss you off.
You can blink though.
Yeah, yeah. Take that. 590 damage.
Yeah.
Well. The high ground push.
I'm totally getting AC, guys.
How do you stop this high ground push? Serpent Wards are there. Tier 3 is going to fall. Rack's likely going to die as well. You have a glyph, but you can't glyph yourselves against this no one Bristleback.
What happened to my lone druid with all that range? Valve, help! Where's my Lina? She's taking tier 3 though, to be fair. This is kind of working out pretty well as far as things could go for you when you're down 6,300 gold.
She's not getting enough damage done. VP, are you going to commit here? Glyph is gone, so you could go for Rax. One of them TP's back, two of them TP back. They are retreating. Now, PD, can you get a catch? Can you find anyone on the back end of this VP retreat? It is just no one who's showing. Everyone else smoked. The Bristleback is the only target they could go for, and he's definitely not the one that they want to go for. So Lina had to retreat from bot lane. Didn't get the tier 3 tower. Just a bit of chip damage there as Ramses completes an Echo Saber. So Armlet, Blink, Echo after Hand of Midas. Kind of small items.
He's gonna annihilate this bear though. If he gets his mitts on it. Oh my god. I really want to see a blink on this bear.
You want to see a blink on the bear? Yeah.
No, I want to see him blink on the bear.
Okay.
That's an old meme right there.
Bear blink. Mm.
You needed the energy booster to make it work, though, for the medic bear.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Or the Dagon bear.
Yeah.
The Sol Ring bear. The energy booster Sol Ring.
Yeah. Mech and blink dagger.
That was
just
a good
blink
stuff.
And use your soul ring and heal everyone. You need the mana cost for your blink though.
Oh, hello, PD, looking for Pasha. There's the Doom. And I've got the break as well, so this means no ulti from Abaddon. The trouble is, there's VP on the high ground, and now they run down straight into the rest of PD. They'll take two with them. TP from Garter will complete. He gets away, so a two for one. Losing your two supports to the offlaner is, you know, not bad, but it's not amazing either. Like, the gold exchange there is minimal. Minimal.
Yeah, it's like a 40 net worth positive. A little bit of experience too, but not going to bite into this lead of VP whatsoever.
And VP just runs straight towards the towers, the top lane, realizing that it's, again, you know, free gold to be taken. Shrine available, of course, since they took the tier 3. Top lane,
credit
Kaiser.
Credit to Kaiser, though, yeah. Honestly. He's doing what he can.
He's got the help of the Spirit Bear, though, to be fair. You know, Spirit Bear's there to kind of tank and help clear wave with the Dragon Slave from the Lina.
Right, but the ward's really necessary solo. That seems acceptable.
Yeah.
Tier 1, no well, backdoor, you drop wards.
I guess you're dropping wards and you're running away. Roshan,
they
could be up soon.
I don't know. That was a little silly.
He just really, really wanted to secure it. Wait, hang on a second. Solo, why do you have so many bracers? I said two bracers.
I like this strategy. Need more bracers. This is the I'm going to buy drums and Atos eventually build. Three bracers and a hood. I'm down.
Cool, I guess.
This is I mean, he keeps watching this Io get Laguna, and he's like, that's not going to be me. I'm going to buy three bracers and a hood.
Not happening to me. Not happening to me.
Oh, Kaiser. Missed that. Dragon Slave. He's alright now, though.
Kaiser might get
maybe
found.
He's not so alright, though.
Does Lil have reveal? He's got dust over on the IO. He definitely does. Kaiser just farming on the very line here between the two regions. VP. They see Kaiser. They don't see J4 or 3-3 behind him, though. No one with no Aegis, but he's got Heart now. Killing him is close to impossible. So PD, they move deeper into the jungle looking for someone else. Ramsey's not the target you want to go for either, thanks to reincarnation. So PD don't really get anything. Relocate. Going forward. Nice LSA. Maybe they can kill the Io this time. Laguna Blade, where is it? No, not going to throw it. Milan stole. TP's before the stun connects. He even got back to Fountain with all those quill sprays stuck over all over him. Just VP securing Roshan though.
Yeah. Hey, where's the fancy new immortal? No one. I just noticed. Come on, man. Not me all cool with that weird pig nose. There it is, the hood.
Oh,
solo living. He's hooding.
Oh, he canceled his shackles. Error.
Oh no.
Little mistake. Little mistake there. I think they could have had that as well with Lil coming in.
Oh. Well played.
they had Lil tether, they had dust. Solo had the shackles, they could have healed him. The serpent wolves were doing damage. And Abaddon was coming. That could have been a kill.
You're not playing Enigma, you know? That's way worse.
Canceling a black hole is way worse than canceling shackles for sure. Bot lane was shoved in here by PD. Three heroes trying to get something done, but the TP's come through very quickly from Virtus Pro. This 3-3 bear is just going around collecting bounty runes, Midas and creeps. He's, you know, pretty big. Radiant Vlad's nearly AC. It's just not as big as you'd like at this moment in time.
Rasta is just bracing himself for action. That's pretty funny. All right. That's my one opening of chat during the game. I appreciate that. That's like the best possible hope when you open up chat randomly during a game. Doesn't get much better than that. Excellent puns.
An amusing pun, yeah. Perfect. Satisfactory punnage. Well played.
Not satisfactory losing your stride.
No.
Go to work.
Easy, easy, easy shrine. Easy shrine. And where did PD go? They start split pushing again. Top lane, Kaiser. He is alone. Could get relocated on here, and he will actually. The dust, is it going to be in range? No. No, it will not. I like the attempt, though. VP just, you know, putting the fear into PD. J4 still lurking around, though, with Kaiser behind him. I don't know if they're looking for a kill onto someone. No one definitely isn't someone. No one is no one.
No. You're not going to get that Aegis down.
No one is not someone you want to try and kill.
But who is? Who's on first?
Someone else. All right. Not no one.
Shadowblade done now for Garter. They do need two Silver Edges, to be fair, but he's not even thinking about it. Just Shadowblade.
Yeah, oh, he is. He switches watch, it. So. He heard you, Trent. He's listening.
Yeah. He's like, wait a second. You're right. It's a bad Nandus Bristleback.
So many things, but Garta might get found. Ramses. Scouting with a little Sata. Very nicely played. Stun comes out. Garta fighting this against the uphill Ramses Wraith King. The Invis comes out from the Shadow Blade. There's Solo with a sentry, but nicely played. Garta decides to run to the south and then around instead of back into the rest of VP.
Like, you see all these heroes and you still can't do anything with this Bristle. And no one's going to TP bottom as his bots are now complete.
I mean, you can't do anything about this Rax taking. You have a glyph, but Serpent Wards are dropped. Nothing really to deter VP from just going into your base. No one, yeah, he just runs in from bot lane to mid lane.
Silver Edge.
He goes straight on through. Now, what do you do? Well, Kaiser looks like he might die. The Shrines are popped, the Nightmare's there, slows things down, the Shiver's Guard spammed out as well, but no one. He's taking no damage whatsoever. He runs forward into all five heroes of PD without taking a single point of damage.
I think Rainy's and all this spell skill might be good, guys. What do you think?
That's pretty good, to
with
be honest.
The heart, maybe? Is that alright?
What is this? What's this?
I'm trying to watch his HP go down. Oh, the bear, you mean? Top lane taking a tier 3? That's pretty impressive.
I mean, that's happening, but I've got like a visual glitch on my screen. Relocate comes through, and Ramses, he's got stun in a second. Not fast enough, though. Bot lane. Swap back onto Pasha. Hex from Solo. Let's lock one down. The Lina's
core. I think they might clean them up.
I think PD get a couple of kills here.
Oh,
no one arrived. Hello, Pasha. He's got Lotus Orb.
Get off my sustaining support, people.
J4.
I'm an offlaner. You're not a core. I'm the core.
Whacked into the ground. And no one's chasing the bear. But no, I saw this weird thing on my screen where, you know, heroes with cool sprays in them, they have cool sprays sticking out of them, right?
Yeah.
So there was a ghost of a hero that looked like it was running around. I think it was like a ghost of the Lone Druid. Oh, shit. Goodbye, Lil. Very nicely played there. Blythe back into the game, relocating in as well. The doomed up bristle back, entangled here, but still able to just stand his ground. Full HP, turns around. Milan will take a bit of damage from the Radiant's burn as well, but they find the kill on the Abaddon. Where did the Wisp go? No. No one is just 1v4ing. 1v3ing now as he's killed off one. Garter, he's got to run away. He can't stand and
got
fight.
Got half his HP, guys.
Lina's arriving, but the swap there. Garter stuns up no one. Kaiser, Shiver's Guard.
Here's the Aegis.
Trying to control him up. The Aegis, you're right. It has been taken out. The relocate from Lil sends him home, though. And they could bring him back on full HP. The rest of VP, they've got, what, Solo running down here as well.
Oh, Ramses think he will. Up the Shaman's coming in.
I think they come in. I think they come and fight this. They'll bring back both. The LSA will land, but the BKB's there. No one runs in forward. The Laguna Blade onto Lil. He heals himself up, barely surviving, but will finally drop to the Lina. But in the meantime, no one. Yul Scepter on that Kaiser. Lina will keep her safe with the Silver Edge as well. Have a draw. 3-3 tries to TP. Solo with the Shackles, though, and this will be the end of the Lone Druid. Enfeeble does a little bit, but 3-3 just being slowed to oblivion as the damage comes through little by little, tickling him down, chicken form, and then dead. But Pro look like they've got this game on lockdown, but Wraith King actually died in the back end to Kaiser. Solo dropping low, the cheeses pop, Milan chasing through the Serpent Wards, Kaiser Yule's in the air as well. LSA. Timed to perfection, and yet another kill for PD. Kaiser He's clearing up. So VP are all dying except for no one. He's looking for another barracks, ranged one mid to fall, but they've got the lockdown with the Fiend's Grip and the damage coming through. They finally bring him down. No one. The second death of this game. Oh boy.
Kaiser has played exceptionally well. I mean, he's the reason this game wasn't just over, because the split pushing. You know, he forced back Ramzes on that very first initial push through the mid lane. He's been getting crazy split push off, and now he's actually 16-1-1. That's so impressive, considering. Sadly, though, I mean, you've lost two melee racks. It's probably not going to be enough. You have two range racks that are just barely hanging on.
Ooh. Full plus.
Some miraculous plays. Well, that's good. There's no point for buyout. I agree on this one, or rather, no point for buyback. Better to buyout.
The trouble is, Bristol has the BKB. 9 seconds, yeah. Relatively fresh.
Yeah, that was quite the surprise to come back with that relocate, eh? Let me just pick up a 10-second BKB surprise.
Move up towards top lane. PD committing for this solo. Not gonna get jumped on. Nice sentry. Spots out the observer ward, freshly placed by Pro Dota, and Ramzes clears through it with one swipe. Focusing down these barracks, but the Serpent wants to drop defensively. Melee is falling, that damage is insane! Blade mail from Ramzes makes sure that PD don't kill him off
mid
or
lane,
focus
they
him
get
down.
The range.
This is big for Pro Dota, they kill the bear. Roshan's up soon as well. We'll find out at the very least.
We're evened up. That is unbelievable. They find this moment again. I mean, they saw him come back with a fresh 10-second BKB, so they're probably like, well, I mean, what are the odds this guy has buyback, right? Like, pretty damn low after he plays like that. So, because of all that gold coming through, despite just buying that Bloodthorn, buyback has now just ticked back over for Kaiser too.
And look at that, Aghanim Scepter for Doom.
So we have two Silver Edges. He has the gold on Garter if he wants to buy out.
Oh, they missed Milan with the smoke though.
Just a moment.
Roshan is a long respawn. 2.5 minutes until the big man returns. VP, not expecting the Ags on Doom, I don't think, but they're grouping up and smoking themselves. They'll walk in 4v4 in the jungle. They jump the stun onto the lone druid. They'll find him, but in the back, Lil's already been obliterated. Kaiser with the DD rune and the Bloodthorn. Looks for the stun, lands onto a bad, and they'll kill off Milan. Oh, the Nightmare holds him in place, but is this BKB plus doomed up Bristleback? Trouble is the Doom is dead. And now the turn from Virtus Pro. A turn to run and hide as Pasha being chased down here by Garter, and they finish him off with Kaiser. But yeah, now 18-1-2, the gem has been dropped, and PD, oh god, there's no buybacks on VP.
No. I mean, this is when Doom does work on Bristle. This is what, I mean, even if he didn't have the Aghanim Scepter, this is the time of game to do it, right? Early on, when he just has a Radiant to, like, you know, you don't really want to Doom him, because he's still just going to be putting out essentially the same amount of damage, but he can't stack Dooms, he can't just run at you with Pill Spray, he can't abuse his whole kit.
Savage Roar sends Ramzes back, but the Bloodthorn, the swap back in with the Fiend's Grip, and no
god,
one's dead.
They won.
No
they
buyback,
won.
That's game over. That's actually game over.
Wow. Maybe they went a little ham in the Radiant base.
Oh, dearie me. Mega creeps are there. Maybe it's not game over just yet. Getting a little bit ahead of ourselves.
Close it. Well, I don't know. You could think about risking the closeout, I would think, but they're not going to.
Radiant base.
Are they?
Radiant base is still open. There could be a relocate play into tier 4s. Doom, Milan holding the line there, trying to defend against these creeps. But the mega creeps are spawning and they are wandering themselves up towards the Dire base. 45 seconds, GG is called. It's just over. They're not even going to try to go for a backdoor play. First Pro, what happened?
I mean, that was kind of a... They just didn't play around the bristles, right? They were like, oh, we won. I don't know. They just thought they thought it was over, I think. They were just like, there was a Wraith King at the top, and he just got soloed, and Bristle just by himself and kind of gooning, and they came back in with that relocate. It was kind of cheeky, you know what I mean? Come back in with the snakes and stuff when they could have just backed away and maybe just slowed themselves there. Impressive. Man, Kaiser owned this game. 19-1-2, goddamn.
How much damage?
Very impressive.
How much damage did he have? Let's have a look at the scoreboard.
I would say all of it.
40,000. I mean, no one had 49,000, but Kaiser did a lot of damage that game.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen so many, like, solo core drafts of Shadow Fiend and Venge, but Lina works similarly well, especially when you can just farm up these stacks again. Man, impressive stuff.
Well, we're going to a game number three then, I guess. I was fully expecting that one just to be closed out by VP2-0, but PD, they're still in this. Are we going to see what happened yesterday with Team Empire beating VP2-1 after losing game one?
What's a cheesy pick that Pro Dota run? They need their Chappie Arc Warden equivalent. We'll have to see if they can whip one out here.
Yeah, I mean, Milan Earthshaker? I don't know. The Kaiser Invoker? I don't know if they're cheesy, but they're kind of the signature picks. I guess the TB for Garter is probably the biggest one that they tend to win with a lot, but wow. Game two going the way of PD. Game number three coming up in just a little bit. We'll get ourselves into the lobby, and we will we'll take a short break now and bring game number three to you in just a little bit. I am in shock. Like, I was mentally prepared for that game to end as a VP victory. I'm just like, PD? Well played. Well played. See you guys in a little bit.